Well, there's the library, and that's the reason why I call it my library route. What we're gonna do is we're gonna wind ourselves around down this whole neighborhood and end up back down by the scrapyard that's down here to the left. But it's closed now. It's 5:26. So we won't be going to the scrapyard right now, but or after this, but looks like first dumpster we check's gonna have a printer, and there's really not much scrap value in these things, and some scrap yards won't take the glass, and you gotta break the glass and stuff, so I'll remove its ink tanks though. I like ink tanks. You can sell them on eBay or use them for the gold plate or whatever. But there's definitely a market for used ink tanks, even if they're empty, you know. I'm just gonna leave that printer there. It's mostly plastic and glass. I'm shooting this one in 4K today. See how that 4K looks. This bike trail right here, that's a really nice bike trail. They just put it in a few years ago. It goes right through the heart of town, and it's like, I think they spent like $36 million building the thing, but it's well worth it because it's a real slick trail, that's for sure. Ooh. Well, maybe I won't be able to do this entire route. Not if I start finding stuff on every dumpster I want. Look at that. Chainsaw action. That's well worn. That's probably just gonna be scrap metal. But normally I'd cut the brass ends off of there. But since I'm showing you my route, and actually that's a nice bit of chicken wire there too. And it's looking like some stainless steel. So yeah, stainless steel down there too. So I'm going to come back to this dumpster. I'm not gonna mess with it right now because I want to show you this route. And it looks like there's a fridge back there. I cut the cord off that. I'll make a note of that dumpster for sure and come back to it afterwards.
really a beautiful time of year out here. Leaves have just came in on these trees. Actually, they're not all the way in yet. This is a very dangerous little driveway right here. Totally blind. I had no idea that train was there. That'll get your heart going, huh? That big dog there is not usually there. That's a new one. I think this is like a storage place for what they're building down there somewhere. Oh, nice little pieces of short steel here. Got a wire down
That's a garbage can. Tin garbage can. It's hardly worth anything. I think I'll just sort steel though. What's in here? Nothing. Bunch of dirt. Take that.
It's not bad. Looks like just a bunch of garbage in there. Yeah. Looks like there was some aluminum scrap in there actually. I'm not gonna mess with that. A lot of those guys are working there. I might come back, have a look at it later. It was clearly a garbage can though. Like when you see those dumpsters that have only metal, you want to stay out of those. But when the dumpsters have, you know, metal and wood and plastic and garbage, and you know, when it's clearly a garbage container, there's really no problem taking stuff out of the garbage. But you want to avoid messing around with the metal only dumpsters, because someone's clearly saving that for profit, so you don't want to mess with that. I've never actually counted these dumpsters before until I started making YouTube videos. I'm not counting them right now. I'm just gonna count them later when I'm editing. I live in an area where cans don't have that deposit. They just buy them by the pound. So when you see me skip cans, I'm really not losing out on money because it's by the pound. So if I pick up 25 aluminum cans, that's a pound. If I pick up 35 aluminum cans, that's a pound. See what I'm saying? empty. Ah, the motor's in there though. I'll snatch that up. Now, dumpster diving can actually be quite dangerous. You see me hopping into these things. I've just been doing it so long. Something's making noise, you hear that? Some kind of electronic gizmo in one of these bags, hear that? It's right here. What do you think that is? But it's this, what's that? Is it a drone? That might be a drone. Hold on a second. What that is? Ah! It's a cat toy. That's a pretty cool little cat toy. You know what? I might have to take that home. That's dirty, though. My cats will love that thing, though. How you turn it? Nah, I better leave it here. It's dirty. And I don't know how to turn it off, so... I don't want to listen to that thing forever. Neat little toy though. I'll give him an A plus on that. But yeah, dumpster diving is actually dangerous. I've just been doing it so long. I just second nature, you know. There could be a board in there with nails on it and glass and insulation and all kinds of dangerous stuff in there. So be careful. This is the local major university campus. We're on the edge of the campus right here. And lately the campus hasn't really wanted people dumpster diving on their property, so I just avoid it. See, these ones here have been on my route for like almost 10 years, so that's right on the fringe of campus, so I'll have a peek in there. That's it. The main reason why the campus, why the university doesn't want people dumpster diving is it's not the dumpster divers, it's when school ends and everyone's moving out of the dorms and frats and stuff, and people will come and start harassing them for their old stuff, you know, and just it makes moving in and out real difficult, so they've just been telling people not to do it. Can you notice I've done this before? Now, sometimes it might look like I'm going really fast, but I'm not. I always stay inside of my bubble of control. I don't ever exit that. Cool fountain right there, check that out. That's not bad. I see this here. That's all the city recyclables. I don't ever mess with that. As far as I know, it's illegal to take stuff out of there. When containers are marked like that, that actually makes it someone else's property. Those recycle bins like that. But garbage cans, there's no problem as long as they're in the public domain. Of course, that law could change one day, but it's not changed today, so. That's just a bunch of garbage in there. So what do we got here? How about this aluminum chair? Yeah, that's a nice little chair. Take that. Now, I have to. My chainsaw's causing me trouble. Let's see what's in here, real quick. Nothing. I found a electric motor in this one once. It was so heavy I couldn't get it out. I think it was an elevator, electric motor out of an elevator shaft. That's what I think it might have been. That was so heavy, I couldn't lift it out of there. Looks like it's time for the bungee cords. Well, let's see what's going on here. Stick that blade through there like that. Leave myself a little gap here. Alright. Enough delay. I don't think I kicked that box, did I? Nothing. It's just wet. Worth much, but when they're empty, I'll take those. When they're full, there's really not a whole lot I can do with them. Confetti? Is it sniffy? No! Get away from me! Easter lilies. Right as the bell starts. Right as the bell starts dinging. That's good timing. guess that means it's 6 o'clock, huh? If you're a property owner and you want a gate to put in front of your dumpster, that's the style you want right there. You gotta see those signs so the garbage truck doesn't lift it up into those power lines. Hope they pay attention every time. See, I don't mess with that kind of stuff up on people's personal property like that. That's all steel. I'm not even gonna bother with that. Take this can, no. Wait a second. Hold the presses. What do we got here? Little sun. Oh, wow, look at that. Got a couple fan mowers. This is gonna be a little time consuming. There's actually a few of them down there. I'm just gonna make a note of this and come back to it. I don't want to bore you guys. So I got this one, fan motors here, and that other dumpster at the beginning that had the stainless steel and the chicken wire stuff in it. So that's two dumpsters I'll come back to. Just a bunch of cardboard boxes. And some kind of boots sitting there. A little nasty, worn. Some shoes. Oh, beat up. It's just a bunch of garbage in there. I don't think I've ever found anything in that dumpster right there. So we're not even gonna go look. It's a dead dumpster. Actually looked like it might have had a padlock on it too. Which is new. Hey, there's a little something something. This dumpster here belongs to, as you can well see, AT&T. Guess I didn't really have to tell you who this belonged to. Of course, you might not have seen that, I suppose. This chainsaw is causing me problems. That's just because it's a goofy shape with the teeth on there that catches everything. Oh well. There, that's gonna be a little better. There we go. Now we're ready. See, that's one thing you want to watch out for. See that? Nasty. The nasty, nasty. Someone's chew can, tobacco dip can. Those are the gross. That's one of the grossest things out here, really. Grill in there, I'm not gonna mess with that. 4 cents a pound, that weighs maybe 7 or 8 pounds, maybe 10 pounds, if there's charcoal stuck in it. It's like, that grill right there is for like maybe 50 cents of scrap metal, 30 cents, 40 cents, thereabouts. So that's really no big deal to skip that. That's where I made that police video at, obviously. There's something in there. There's something, no, it's plastic. Something right there. What was it? There it is. Oh, something. Ah, movie projector. Old school. Aluminum case. I'll take that. I don't rip bags open very often, but when I feel something heavy in there, I'll do it. That's nothing. That's just a bunch of garbage. Heard a K-9 unit in one of those trucks. That's the police dumpster right here. Started putting a padlock on that one. Ouch. Look where we ended up at. Imagine that. Not a bad little route. See, now normally if the scrap yard was open, I'd go down here and take a lift. But it's not. So I'm gonna go back this way. I just wanted to show you where we ended up at. There's a few dumpsters I didn't hit still, so I guess they're on the way to the scrapyard, so we'll go have a look at that. See, the scrapyard's way down there. See that? See where that semi truck's at? The scrapyard's right down there. Looks like we got a little humidifier action going. Let's see. Whoa, that ground is soft. Give me some rocks. There we go. Well, I was gonna check this out to see if it was working, but after that, I don't think it's worth it now. Well, that's just falling apart. But, oh well. I'm definitely not gonna take the time to mess with it now. It's just turned into instant scrap metal. Probably what it already was, but now it's definitely a scrap metal. Uh-oh, that can's not all the way empty. Alright, so that one's already had a couple of lives. Look at that, $8 at the Goodwill. But it's been sitting out here in the rain, so I'm not one to take electronics that have been sitting in the rain and try to sell them to someone. So that's scrap metal now. I probably would have scrapped it anyways, but sitting in the rain is definitely scrap metal to me. See, that's what I thought. I thought there might be something like that in there. Felt a little too heavy. See, normally I'd go right down there, scrapyard, but after hours, so I'm gonna take this to the stash hole. And I'll see you at the stash hole. So I'll just stash it right here. This is my stash hole. A lot of my new subscribers probably haven't seen this yet. I put it in a video a couple months ago, but I think actually someone came and took two of my totes. I had three totes here, but I'll put that one there. Take this one that was still there, and I'll take this copper wire with me because it doesn't take up any room. It's real easy to carry. So now I'm about a mile and a half away from that scrapyard, so I'll just pop in here and grab that stuff one of these days here in the near future and take it to the scrapyard. But it's better than paying, you know, $50 for a storage unit. It's really not that big of a deal with it, you know. It's not hurting nothing. Alright, so I came back to that dumpster just so you guys know I'm not trying to pull one over on you. Cut that hose off of there. Or cut the brass fittings off that hose. That's a nice roll of chicken wire. I wish I had a use for that. I could have used that when I chicken wired my, when I made my deck cat proof. I could have used that for sure, but I'll take that to the scrapyard. I wish I had a use for it. I see this fridge here. You don't ever want to store a fridge. I mean, it's obviously just garbage. It's just disgusting. But you don't ever want to store a fridge like that right there, because little kids will play hide and seek and stuff. And they're liable to, or anyone, drunk college kid hiding from his friends might get in there. And it'll tip over like this, see, like that. And it just became a death chamber, you know what I'm saying? So you always want to store fridges like this. You know, you don't ever want to store them like that. I hope it wasn't an apartment manager that did that. They need to pay attention to what they're doing if that's the case. I'm not gonna mess with the copper lines in this because I stopped a while back releasing that gas out of there because I'm not quite sure what the deal is with it. So I'm just gonna leave that there. That's probably not a lot in there, but oh well. Alright, I'm gonna go get those ceiling fans real quick. See, and there's other dumpsters I still haven't checked. You know, I haven't checked every dumpster here. So it's not like I'm wasting a trip, you know, going back and picking up these fans and this chicken wire and stuff. And there's still plenty of other dumpsters I haven't checked yet right in this area, so. They're just not my my main route dumpsters. These are kind of secondary dumpsters. You know, there's usually not a whole lot of stuff in them. But you know, sometimes there is though, so you know. Take a speaker in there. I'm not gonna mess with that. A mirror down in there. That's kind of an interesting mirror. Let's have a look at that. Oh, that's broken. Oh. I came back for those ceiling fans. There's actually three of them in there. I got the other two loaded up right here. So now you know I wasn't just saying I'll come back. Because I've been known to make notes of stuff and then keep on going towards my house with the route and just forgetting about it, doing other stuff, and then just never going back for it. See, I could go left here, but that's on a different route of mine that I'll show you later. I don't want to go mess with that right now.